Hey guys, hi, very very good evening to all of you and welcome to the session. This is your master teacher Harsh Priyamanam in front of all of you with this new chapter of circles. So today we are going to talk about circles. Yo. So this circle has been brought with a perspective of basic mathematics. So just keep that in your mind. And we will be discussing questions, some good level questions, because in circles, I don't think there is any such theory as such, apart from tangents and chords and radius and center, all those things. So we will be directly jumping into the questions, good level questions, which are most probable from your exam point of view. Okay, so here we go. First theory for all of you is this theorem, which actually says that in a circle, radius is always perpendicular to the tangent. So always just remember this, that in a circle, radius is always perpendicular to the tangent. I'm pretty sure you all might be even knowing that. But if in case someone does not know this, please know this. Second thing, that the proof of this theorem is it's very less probability that it will come in your examination. By the way, if it comes, so I'm just going to tell you in 1 or 2 minutes. See, what you have to do? You have to make multiple lines here. So say for example, you have got a point center O here. You can make one OQ is there. You can make OR, OS, OT like this. And then what you can do, that OQ is there, OR is there, OS there is there. You'll write that OP is less than OQ. From the figure, it is very much evident. OR is less than OP. OP is less than OR. OP is less than OS. Means OP is less than all these lines. So hence, OP is the smallest distance of the point O from the line XY. Yeah, OP is the smallest distance. And we know smallest distance is always the perpendicular distance. So you have to just write this much. That since OP is the smallest one, and we know smallest distance is always the perpendicular distance, hence, we can say OP is perpendicular to the line XY. Fine, that's it. Cool, so you have to just do this. By the way, this proof won't come, but anyways, we learned this. Moving ahead to the question. This is the entire remarks which I just orated. Here's the first question for all of you. Question says, it's a very easy question by the way. Find the length of the tangent drawn to a circle with radius 8 cm from a point 17 cm away from the center of the circle. Means you have a circle, you have drawn a tangent from a point which is 17 cm from the circle and the radius of the tangent is 8. So this is 8, this is 17. Question is asking you find the length of tangent. So O, A, B. Question is asking you AB length. Won't you be able to find it? Man, come on, yes. This is perpendicular. We all know that. Since this is perpendicular, we'll be able to apply Pythagoras. So Pythagoras simply says 17 square equals to 8 square plus AB square. You have to solve it, and once you solve it, you'll be able to find the value of AB. So AB is root under 17 square minus 8 square, 289 minus 6, minus 64, that is 225. So AB would be equals to 15, if I'm not wrong. I hope you all got it. Yes. Okay, let's see whether this answer is 15 or not. Yo, answer is 15, absolutely right. Cool, I hope you all got it. Chalo, moving on, if you all understood, here we go to the next question. The next question says, a point P is at a distance of 29 centimeter from the center of a circle. Okay, a point P is at a distance of 29 centimeter from the center of the circle. So you have a point P, say for example, this is 29 centimeter, and the circle of having a radius is 20, find the length of the tangent. So length of tangent, exactly the same question. This is point P, this is O, this is Q. You have to find PQ. Man, come on, this is like, these are super easy questions. You can just write it in one word. PQ is root under 29 square minus 20 square. If I'm not wrong, this should come as 21. 441. You'll get 841 here minus 400. 841 minus 400 is 441. Root 441 is 21. Like one liner. Simple. And these questions are asked in examination. Let me tell you, I'm not joking. These questions are asked in examination. Fine, I hope you understood that. Let's move on to the next. Next question says, in the given figure, but where is the figure? PA and PB are the tangent segments to a circle with center O. Show that the points A, O, B, P are concyclic. Okay, so figure is not given. I'll still make the figure. I will be able to do that. So here we have got a circle. There is a point P which is making a tangent here, and this is your center O. So this is PA and PB, two tangents, PA and PB. And you have dropped a perpendicular from O. So question is saying that you have to prove that AOBP are concyclic. AOBP, they are concyclic points. Now, how do we prove concyclic? See, concyclic or cyclic quadrilateral do have only one simple property, which we all remember, that sum of opposite angles should be 180 degree. That's it. Simple, plain and simple. So here, first of all, do you know that this is 90 degree and this is 90 degree? Why? Because they are radius. Radius is always perpendicular to the tangent. Yeah. So yes, they are 90 degree. So one part is already done. Angle A plus angle B is equals to 180 degree. Now, if these two angles, opposite angles are 180, automatically these two angles sum would be also 180. Why? Because I know that sum of a quadrilateral, sum of the angles of a quadrilateral is 360. Since these two are already 180, so the remaining two will also be 180. So hence you would be able to write angle O plus angle P is equals to 180. Fine, cool. Okay, so yes, we have proved that. Just one liner, simple. It looks so big and bulky. It may look tough, but it's not tough. Okay, just simple plain words. Just make sure you make the diagram neat and clean. That gives a lot of good impression to the examiner. Okay, moving on to the next question. Okay, it's not over yet. So it's time to actually congratulate the Vedantu JEE rankers. And these are the results which Vedantu has produced this year. So Vedantu is undoubtedly doing outstanding in the field of results also. So it's the only coaching institute in the entire country in online segment which is actually producing results. You can just check it out. So only place. Just imagine how beautiful it is. So these all students have made Vedantu proud, and we are also proud of them. Okay. And hence, I can very confidently say that, guys, it is your time also to join Vedantu and come into that limelight, bring colors to your life and succeed in your life. Yeah. So the link for this is given in the description box. It would be read as vdnt.in/ytpro. You can click on that link and browse through your courses. Once you find your course, you can join that. At the end of that payment page, you will find a coupon code option. There you have to put HP Pro for getting an extra discount just before the payment. Okay, so before payment, just use that coupon code HP Pro. It will give you some extra discount. Okay, chalo, moving on. Here's the next question. This question says find AD. Okay, that is the last line. I'm just concerned with the last line. So I don't know what is AD, but some other things has been given. So question says in this, these all are tangents, these lines to the circle, they are touching at some point, and all other values are given. We have to find AD. Okay, I don't know what is AD. Let's calculate it. Okay, so people, let's see. AD has got two components, AS and DS. I don't know AS, neither do I know DS. So I will assume AS to be X, DS to be Y. Yeah, fine, looks fine. So if this is X, this should be also X. Completely agreed? Yeah. Similarly, if this is X and this entire is 6, you can very easily understand that the remaining portion should be 6 minus X, because this complete is X, this much is X. So this much will be 6 minus X, complete minus X. Yeah. Okay. If this is 6 minus X, without any doubt, you should understand that this is also 6 minus X. Why? Okay. Why am I doing this? Sorry, I forgot. I have not taught you this. I hope you all might be knowing that in a circle, if there is an external point which is making two tangents, tangent 1 and tangent 2, they are of equal length. Always remember, from an external point, if you draw two tangents to a circle, they are always of equal length. So, A is an external point. From here, we have got two tangents, tangent AP and tangent AS. And that is why I took their side lengths to be equal. Similarly, B is an external point. From here, we have got two tangents, BP and BQ. That is why I took their length equal, 6 minus X, 6 minus X. Okay, so always just remember that. Fine, so if you have understood this, I hope you will be understanding that since this is 6 minus X and this entire is 7, this entire length BC is given 7 centimeter. So if entire BC is given 7, if I talk about CQ, that would be 7 minus this length, which is 6 minus X. So 7 minus X is 1, 1 plus X. So this is 1 plus X or X plus 1, whatever you wish, you can say that. So we have got X plus 1 here, CQ. If CQ is X plus 1, surely RC will also be X plus 1, external point, X plus 1. If this is x plus 1 and this entire is 4, so you can do 4 minus x plus 1. Yeah, 4 minus x plus 1, so that will bring 3 minus x. 3 minus x. Yeah, cool. Okay, so if you have got this 3 minus x, then this 3 minus x must be equal to y without any doubt, because obviously d is again an external point. From an external point, you have got a tangent ds and dr. So they should be of equal length. So you will write that this implies y is equals to 3 minus x. Now, what was asked from you? You were asked ad. AD is nothing but x plus y, which we assumed. So if AD is x plus y, just send this x to this side. You will get x plus y equals to 3. And balle balle, we got the answer. X plus y is 3 centimeter, and that is the length of AD. I hope you all understood, isn't it? So it was a very simple thing, just like a puzzle game, isn't it? Not like mathematics. Fine, I hope you all understood. If you understood, let's move on to the next question. Here we go. Let's check the answer as well. So AD is 3 centimeter. They have done this big blah 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 thing. We don't need to do that. You can just do it in the figure. Okay. Moving ahead, here's the next question, people. This next question says something. Let's see what it says. Find the length of side AB and AC. That's what it says precisely. Okay, that's cool. And apart from that, this question says that this is 6 and this is 9. So one thing I know for sure, if this is 6, surely this is also going to be 6, still here. Because from an external point, tangents are of equal length, BD. And similarly, let's DEF, you can say E and this is F. So BD and BF, they would be of equal length. So 6. If this is 9, surely this is also going to be 9. Yeah, simple. Okay, I did that simple. Now the thing is, key question is saying that area of this triangle is 54 centimeter square. Okay, 54 centimeter square. So now what we have to do, we have to find the length of side AB and AC. So in this AB and in this AC, only one part is missing, which is AF and AE, which are equal. So if I assume AF to be X, AE will also be X. Huh? Yeah? Okay. I have to find that X. Let's see how we will be able to find it. So one more thing has been given in this question, if you are able to see. That is the radius of the circle. That is the radius of the circle. So what I can do, I can simply join all the vertices from the center and break this triangle into three triangles. Break this triangle ABC into three triangles, that is OAB, OBC and OCA. Yeah. And why did I do that? Because that is going to give me some benefit. Let me show you. Once I have got this, I have got this triangle also. I have got this perpendicular OD, because radius is perpendicular to the base. One more perpendicular I would be able to get it, that is OF. This would also be 3 centimeter because radius. And one more perpendicular I would be able to get, that is OE, which is again perpendicular, which is 3 centimeter. Again, 3 centimeter. Okay, cool. So we have got OD, OE, OF, 3. I want to write that, are you understanding, area triangle ABC, please pay attention, area triangle ABC can be written as area triangle OAB plus OBC plus OCA. I hope you won't mind here. ABC could be written as area of these three smaller triangles. And what is the area of these three smaller triangles? Please pay attention. Is equals to half into, if I talk about OAB, here the base, are you able to see the base? 6 plus x, this is the base, and height is 3. Half into base into height, so base is 6 plus x, height is 3. So I'll write half into base into height plus OBC, again half into base into height, so base is 6 plus 9, 15. So half into 15 into height is 3 plus OCA, again half into base into height, half into base is 9 plus x into height, 9 plus x into height is 3, again 3. Fine. And this area triangle ABC is already given in the question itself, 54. Yes or no? Given. Now you would be able to see, or you would be able to see it so well, that everywhere half and three, that is common, half and three. So I'll just take out half and three, that is 3/2. Half and 3 taken common means 3/2. Remaining is 6 plus x, 15, and 9 plus x. So just add them 6. Okay, let me write it down here. 6 plus x plus 15 plus 9 plus x. This is remaining here. 9 plus x, 15 and 6 plus x is equals to here 54. So now if you want to cancel out, you can. Why not? 3 will cancel out this in 18 times, if I am not wrong. This will go here. 18 into 2, that is nothing but, let me write it here, 36 equals to. Please pay attention. 6 plus 9, 15. 15 plus 15, 30. So I have got 30. And then plus x, we have got 2x. So I have got 2x. 30 plus 2x. 30 will go to that side. So hence 60 equals to 2x. So that brings x is equals to 3. Balle balle. We got the side. X is 3. So 3 and 3. So 6 plus 3, 9. And 9 plus 3, 12. 9 and 12 are the sides. Yeah. It was easy, man. It was easy. It was not at all tough. Believe me. They see here. X equals to 3. They have done this blah, blah, blah. Again, the same way. What we did. 54 half into base into height. Half into base into height. That's it. Simple. Yeah. Chala, let's move on to the next one. Here's the next one. It's a beautiful question. If you see, this might appear very tough to you. But otherwise, it is easy. So for solving this question, you just need one beautiful thing. And what is that one beautiful thing? You need to understand alternate segment theorem. You need to understand alternate segment theorem. So everyone, just pay attention. Let's assume that this is a circle and this is a tangent. Now on the contact point, just draw a chord. So this chord has made two angles with a tangent. One is a smaller angle, one is a bigger angle. So, smaller angle is on the minor side of the circle. This is the chord. Let's name it AB. So, AB has divided the circle into two segments, minor segment and major segment. So, AB is making an angle with a tangent, a smaller angle on the minor side. So, this angle, if I assume this angle to be X, this angle X would be equal to the angle made by this AB chord in the major segment. What I said? Angle made by this AB chord in the major segment would be equal to the angle made by this chord AB with the tangent in the minor part. Minor may, the angle which it has made, this is also X and this is also X. They are equal. Ye aisa hota hai. This is a fact. And this theorem is called as alternate segment theorem. Why alternate? Because if one of the angle is in the minor segment, it would be equal to the angle in the major segment. Both made by the same chord. So the same ideology you have to apply here. Now please pay attention. Here you have got a chord. And this chord has a contact point P. From P there is one more chord. This is PA. So PA is making an angle in the major segment. What is that? That is angle 30 degree. PA is making angle PBA 30 degree. That angle would be equal to the angle made by this chord in with a tangent. So this angle would also be 30 degree. That which I wanted to tell you. I hope you all understood till here. So this is 30 degree. Fine. Now if this is 30 degree, please pay attention. I hope you are understanding that AB is a diameter. So if AB is a diameter, surely it would be a 90 degree. Diameter always makes 90. So this is 90, this is 30, surely this is 60 degree. Without any doubt. If this is 60, this is 30. Exterior angle property, you can very easily figure it out that this is 30 again. Easy. These things are not tough. So this is 30, this is 30, this is 60. We are able to figure it out till here. Fine. If this is 30, very easily you figure out that this is equals to this. Okay, cool. Fine. Now let me just pull out this triangle ABP outside. So if I pull out this triangle ABP outside and if I make it like this, angle P is a 90 degree. So P is here. Angle B is 30 degree. Let be this here. B is 30 and A is 60 degree. So this is 60. This is 90. Cool. You would be able to see that AB is nothing but radius and radius 2 radius. AB is 2 radius. So AB is 2 radius. If I have to find AP, which is here, base, I know hypotenuse, I have to find base. I would be applying trigonometric ratio, cos, if you do understand that. So I would simply write cos 60. Cos 60 is what? Base upon hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is 2r equals to cos 60. You all know cos 60 is 1 by 2. Cos 60 is 1 by 2. Fine. So you would be able to see that AP by 2r equals to 1 by 2, and hence AP is equals to r. AP is equals to r. So AP is r. Now you might be thinking, sir, why this much of haste? Why this much of haphazard thing that this is r? Why are you even finding that this is r? What does it mean to you? So I would say, now just read the entire question. Or if you don't want, or if you are a lazy like me, don't read the entire question. Just read that at the end you have to prove BA is to AT, 2 is to 1. BA is to AT, 2 is to 1. Means BA is double of AT. So BA was 2R already, 2 times radius, BA was 2R. I had to prove that AT is equals to R radius. And so I did this whole Ramayana. Because from this 2R, I was able to prove that AP is equals to R using trigonometry. So once I proved AP equals to R, I already had proved that this is an isosceles triangle. So if AP is R, surely AT will also be R. And hence, I prove BA is to AT, 2 is to 1. Agreed? Yeah? Chalo. If you all agree, this is the final solution. By the way, if you'll go by the solution given here, it's a very big and long thing, not required this much. So I hope you understood the previous one. Cool? Chalo, moving on to the next question. Here we go. So this is the entire solution. They have used sine 30, we have used cos 60. Does not make a difference. Here's the next question, and it's a beautiful one. Question says, prove AC equals to CB. How are we going to prove that? Super easy, man, super easy. This is AC, AB is a tangent to the smaller circle. Okay. Let's drop a perpendicular. Means let's join O to C. You know that whenever center is joined with a contact point of the tangent, it is a 90 degree. We already know this. It's a 90 degree. We have to just prove that AC equals to BC, that this 90 degree is bisecting it. What we will do, we will simply join O to A and O to B. Done. You know OA and OB is radius for the bigger circle. Let's assume capital radius R. For the bigger circle, it's radius. So they would be equal. So this side is equals to this side. Yeah? Yeah. This side is already common to both of them. Agreed? Agreed. Right angle is always equal. R is always equal. Right angle. So in triangle OCA, triangle OCA and OCB, I was able to find that OC equals to OC, common, one side is equal, and then I was able to find OA equals to OB, which is radius, and then I was able to find that angle OCA is equals to angle OCB, which is equals to 90 degree. So what I did actually, I did right angle equal, I did hypotenuse equal, I did one side equal. Right angle, hypotenuse and side. And hence, I can write that using RHS congruency criteria, these two triangles are congruent. So these two triangles, triangle OCA is actually congruent to triangle OCB. OCB. Using RHS. Since they are congruent, AC is equals to BC by CPCT. Agreed? Simple, no? It's not tough, no? Looking like big, bent, bulky and tough. But it's not tough actually. Okay? Chalo, let me show you the final entire solution. They have done this blah, 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 blah thing. We don't need it. RHS they have also used the same way they also did. Okay? Fine. So that was all, folks, for this session. It was a wonderful session with you all. So if you like the session, as like me, hit the like button and subscribe the channel. Share it with your friends also. And those who want to join Vedantu's live session and be like the topics which I showed you in the starting, you can actually go to the link given in the description box. That would be reading as vdnt.in/ytpro. Once you click on this link, you'll be having a page like this. Here you have to select your grades, then your boards. Once you select all of them, a page like this will appear. Click on get subscription. Once you click on get subscription, a subscription page will be opened like this. Here, choose your subscription, whatever suits you. At the final payment page, just apply a coupon code here, HPEPRO. This HPEPRO will actually give you an extra 15% discount over the discounted price. over the discounted price an extra discount. And hence, you'll be able to buy this course at a lesser price. Okay? So people, this is the best time to join Vedanto, because Vedanto is flying high and everyone riding Vedanto is doing outstanding. Okay? So I'll be waiting for all of you in that session. Till then, bye-bye, take care and good night. Bye-bye.